Let's talk about statistical significance. So very known Evan Miller, you can find who is it on the website. But what is significance? Sometimes we do experiment, and I very recommend you to watch the video about data-driven learning before. So when we do some experiments or split testing, we need statistical proof that it works or it doesn't. So we need enough data. So quite known guys, Evan Miller, you can find about him at the bottom of the page, slogan.org. So mostly we'll use this sample size calculator. Just go to his website, click sample size calculator, you will see the calculator like this. And the idea just, this is base conversions that you measure, and then is detectable effect. So I will show some examples, you will understand how to use a calculator. It will be very easy for you. So let's say we have our website and we do experiment with a title, main slogan, because on the title page we usually have enough traffic, and usually title on the title page really affect your registration. So if we change title to free website builder, then we will increase conversion rate twice. Conversion rate C0 is, as I talked yesterday, it's a conversion to registration, conversion from the first page to registration, because competitor mostly use this slogan. So what kind of our metrics we use? So let's say conversion now is 10%. We would like to double it. Let's say we have per day 1,000 users, and let's say our conversion to payment is 5%. So please notice, like, we measure now only C0, we try to increase our conversion to registration rate, but also we sometimes take also some metrics just to drag them to understand if something happens. Maybe something bad wrong with sales when conversion increase. So how we look at this? So let's do experiment. It means we stopped all slogan and start new one. So our last period, we just have some statistics that in last 20 days, we have about 20,000 users. We got about 2,000 registrations, and it was like 10% conversion, yes. And we know that from 200 registrations, only 100 people bought. So we have C1, it's conversion to the first payment, is 5%. So it was last period. Now we're doing the experiments. And we use formula. We take baseline conversion rate. We know that C0 is 10%. Then we would like to double. It means like minimal detectable effect is relative 100%. So it could be relative 100% or it could be absolute 10%. So absolute, it means like if you have 10%, then absolute 5% will be 50. And you can just use how it's better for you. You can use absolute, like relative here, like 10 plus 100% will be 20%. Or 10% plus 20%, well, 10% will be also 20%. So, and you see like here, this is what's the effect. So to understand if we are outside this range, we need sample size 157 people to experiment. So we need 157 people, but we just, let's say, our growth team is for example, they just run tests every 2 days. So they, after 2 days, they got the same 2,000 visitors. Just this was old website with old slogan and new website with new slogan, yeah? Like, we get the same amount of visitors, let's say 2,000 visitors, and we got a little bit more registration, it's 12%. It means when people see free website builder, somehow more people registered. And then we see like in conversion and payment, we get less payment. We have only 2.5% conversion to the first payment. Please notice that we measure registrations, and registration is our main row. And our plan was to achieve 20%. We achieved only 12. So did we reserve registrations? The answer is no. We didn't reserve the registrations. It's like a little bit shuffle here. One day it could be 9, other day 12. Because our goal was to double. It means like we need to reach 0 or 20. We didn't reach 0 or 20, we reached only 12%. So experiment is negative. So we have hypothesis that if we change the slogan, we will increase registration rate. So result is negative because we didn't twice our results. And by the way, when we write the knowledge, we also write that if we change the slogan, it will not double. Possibly it will increase 20%, but we need to check again. Our goal was if we can double registration. We didn't double. And by the way, we can also write the knowledge that possibly our opinion C1 decreased because people, when they see free, possibly you get more registration, but people are not ready to pay. But we also have no statistical proof, no statistical significant result. So we can also write just an opinion that a little bit decrease sales, but we are not sure about that. Just possibly. So we provide ideas for the next experiment. And by the way, why there are 2,000 people? We plan to have 1,000 people in one day. As we remember, in one day it's 1,000 people, but we see 2,000 people. It's just because unexpected traffic gain. So with unexpected traffic, possibly some blogger wrote about us, possibly it was some holiday, we don't know. So and unexpected traffic also can have their own results. So their own conversions. So people have their own behavior, not as regular users. So usually when you have unexpected traffic and it wasn't split testing, you need to cancel a result as well. So this is negative result. So we got knowledge that the slogan will not double our registration rate. So let's go to next example. Then we understood if we change title to 1 year money back guarantee, then we will increase sales twice, number of sales twice, because Pushkin recommended it. So we have just an idea. If we prove money back guarantee, we will double our sales. Also the same metrics. And let's go deeper. So we have A, we would like to do split testing because last time we did experiment. And when we did experiment, we get unexpected traffic and we also need to cancel the experiment. Now we would like to test this A-B testing. How long we need to test? So now if we have total conversion, overall conversion, we have C0 10% and C1 5%. So we multiply them. So our overall conversion is 0.5%. It means if 1,000 people come to our website, only 5 of them purchase. So our baseline conversion is 0.5%. Because now we calculate not C0, not C1, but we calculate overall conversion. And our goal was to double sales, yes? So we put like relative 100%. And we see that ranges from 0 to 1. So we need sample size, 3,500 per variation. Very important, per variation. If we do experiment, we use this number. If we have split test, A, B, C, D, we need this sample size for every like A, B, or C. So very variant. So, and we do now A-B testing. Old one, A, and new one, B. We get in both, as you see, it's like 4,000 each. So we tested 8 days. After 8 days, we get 4,000 visitors here and 4,000 visitors here. We only needed 3,500 things. We got registration with old title, 400. This new title, we get less registrations. Can you imagine? Wow. We test these titles, we got less registrations. And our registration rate decreased. But what with sales? because we in this hypothesis we calculate purchased. Add that we got 20 purchases here and 40 H purchases here. That is incredible. We double our sales. Just to remind, to double it was enough 40. And C1 in that case was 5%, it didn't change. But with new title, it changed to 20%. So we have total more than 2x sales. So what kind of knowledge we got? We got that if we change title and like blah, 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 then we will increase our sales twice. Can we prove that we increase? Not. We can prove that we ever increased a little bit more than twice. But we also, to measure exact number, we also need more numbers. But now we know that we at least twice increase results. And also we can write that we see that C0 decreased and C1 increased. But we can also enable to say that C0 increased to 6% because also we need to see if it's statistically enough data to prove that C0 decreased. As an expert, I can say that yes, it decreased, but about C1, we also see that increased, but exact number, we don't know. We can also write other hypotheses to specify the data. But what we can prove that sales really increased twice. Well, and before we also get some knowledge, because possibly people afraid to try because they have credit cards, but they don't like to push it because they know the service could be bad. So possibly just because people are afraid to try. So, and also we need to wait 1 year also, because if you have 365 days chargeback, maybe all people will return money after 1 year. So we will know if we totally succeed only after 1 year. Only we know that if we change this title, we will increase our sales twice. That is enough data. So it's statistically significant result. Okay, so example number 3. Our team said we need to faster website. Faster website will provide us more users, we will have more money, blah 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 blah. So it's very complicated to make website faster. So what we do, we try. If website will be slower, nothing changed. So if we decrease loading speed from 1 second to 3 seconds, then nothing will change in C0. Because all websites are slow in this region. For example, we're testing, let's say, in Zambia. Because internet in Zambia not so good. And possibly we just think, should we buy a server nearby or it's just enough? So we decrease loading speed. How it works for us. So we had fast website and slow website. And by the way, when we talk about results doesn't change, we also need how big is the accuracy. So accurate we are. So let's say we just try with a formula. If accuracy should be 1%, so like from 9.1 to 10.1, we would like very accuracy. We need sample size of 1.5 million. So we need to test 5 years with our traffic, 1,000 per year, yeah? So 1,000 per day. So maybe we can take less accuracy. If we take 10% accuracy, it will be from 9 to 11. We need 14,000 users. And because once we got an expected traffic, we will do split testing, so to provide very nice results. And we say in A and B we have similar traffic after 1 month. So if it's numbers after 1 month, because 1,000 people per day, split testing, we need 30 days, yeah? So we got enough traffic. We got registration from A, and from B, from slow website, we got less registration. So C0 was 10% here and 9% here. We also see that some purchases a little bit changed. As I said, you always need to highlight rows that you measure. Other rows are just to provide you additional information. But main row for statistical significance is only one. Yeah, so our goal was, if we decrease loading speed, nothing will change. And we see that conversion decreased from 10% to 9.3. And we start thinking, oh, yeah, we have lower conversion. No. Significant results will be only if we are outside 9 or 11, but we are inside. So because we are inside 9.33, so we can prove that nothing changed. Statistically, nothing changed. It's just some shuffle, some errors in numbers. But statistically, we can prove that if we make our loading speed slower from 1 to 3 seconds, C0 conversion will not change with accuracy 10%. Of course, if you need a better accuracy, okay, no problem, we can test 5 years. And also, if we know that slower loading speed, didn't affect, we know that if you make website instead of 1 second, there are 2 seconds, there will be also no more sales. So we also, and this is accuracy could be also 10%. So with a 10% accuracy, we can set that, with a 10% shuffle like thing, we can prove that if we increase the speed of website, nothing will change. So our hypothesis was positive. Technically, it's usually 1 of 5 or 1 of 10 hypotheses are positive, but we need to test so you know. So we now know how to test. So do your best and get your own experience. And I just show you most powerful and maybe most popular way how to test. Of course, there are lots of ways how to test, like you can do ABI testing and blah, blah, blah. But technically, you now know 99 cases how to test and how to get statistical significant results. Okay? Good luck, guys. See you in the next video.